Okay, so editor name map. That is what I was working on last, and I need to implement that in everything else. Moving along. Now ECS. Okay. I need to move the editor name map to somewhere else so that I can actually use it in things like foe resource. So I'm kind of thinking the resource ID. Okay, maybe. Okay, just move these over up. They're moving up. Moving on up to here. CPP goes on to the source side. We'll include foeECS editor name map. This is a very specific piece. So include foeECS entity ID. Move that, change that to resource ID. Move this ID thing around. Up here for the moment. Resource ID. We need a copyright header. Okay. All locations where we have foeECS resource ID. Place them all, please. Thank you very much. Unless I really do want to have like them separate, which I could do. But for the moment, no. No, no, no. If I can do it later. If so, move that back out. Go to ECS. Editor name map here. Resource does not bring in foeECS right now. I imagine that's the problem here. Yep. ECS. So I need to like okay. Okay, go to application. Let's make sure that it works first, and then we can start moving around. So, actually, no, I can make a test right up here, can't I? Okay. Name map. ECS. ed is before n. Let's get some basics. I don't even have anything for this yet. That's a very useful set of tests. Nope, wrong one. This one. Include. Okay. Does groups at least have tests? Yes. So we can work on this one. See if I can remember how to do it. Okay. Editor ID map. Oh, yes. Initial empty state. I can't even test that actually. Add to T. Okay, require that one to pass. Don't have the tests, so make dash J test foe ECS. Ribs, foe, ECS, test, that. Okay. So one, but this one fails. To That's good so far. Okay, then we... So let's add entity and add resource. That one succeeds. As in, they both do that. Whoops, wrong one. Nope, 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 nope. We can't share a name between the two. Trying to add with an empty name fails. Dating. Okay, we have a full editor name map. What we're going to do is says entity one, and we do the same thing for resource. Source zero, resource one. So then we got a section, I believe it is. False map dot update entity zero, the name of entity that fails. Zero becomes resource one, zero, sorry, one, no. Okay. removals. Resource not in the map fails. Okay, we do those, then we want to like that succeeds. Okay, what was another case I was going to try? Updating with blank names fails. Okay, and we do the same thing with the resource. what really happens here is this. This should be really a section. Can we do that? Okay. Different, adding. And then I need to do for finding of items. And flip this around for resource. Okay, I'm presuming that this is just not. Oh, yes. Do I have code coverage. Elkov not found. What? Am I building GCC? I am. Wow. Why? Why am I doing this to myself? Why am I hurting myself like this? Okay. ECS, do that please. And let me just quickly find, open up the file. Shrink that down to 1080p-ish, move it over. Okay, so what we got for editor name map, very close to full coverage, except for this. If it's invalid entity ID. Ah, yes. Okay, reload that. That's one down. Got one more case to deal with, looks like. Okay, I have it for add entity. What about add resource? Yeah, I already do check that. Okay, so one, what is this? Okay. Attempted to add entity with editor name already in used by. Is it not the same here? Hold on, what? Okay, I need to do the opposite on this then. No, that didn't actually work. Oh, whoops. There we go. Now it's cleared. So that means what? Everything? Yeah, it's fully covered. The whole file's fully covered. These tests now. So I know the functionality is working precisely how I'm thinking it will. So let's clear these guys up and then start adding it to the other items down below. Let's see what else. What are these other items we got going on here? Yeah. Let's get that out of the way then. Resource ID. There you are. We add that. Okay, it's do let's add it now then. So application, HPP, we're adding something to do with these. Should I add it as part of that or? Yeah, okay. Okay. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do is under foe resource, we're going to update the YAMLs. So let's say we'll start with the armature. With the path, create info. I'm thinking is if you pass this in, then it will fill it. Otherwise, it won't. Or, rather than okay, let's just test this with armature. We pass this in. And then in armature public, we have that. This is part of armature. There we go. It'd be part of the root. So we've got root items. If p editor name map not equal null pointer. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. I'm going to read. I need to have the editor, the ID. So okay, what I actually need is that. If it exists, and that, then we go into editor name node like that. And temp. Then we do p editor name map. And what are we? We're a resource. We have the res ID.
Along with temp.
That means we're going to, for armature loader, require passing through this, if we have it. So we pass that in here. Like that. Then down. That armature loader, we go down to the import function, which has changed fundamentally because of this. It's that, right? Comma that. Oh yeah, this is okay, no, we don't need it here, but we can need it down here. Or instead, where we do the armature thing. Yeah, goodbye. Armature that. Map. So an application right about here. Then have, what is it? Easiest name map. That. Oh, that's not going to help because I return that, don't I? Whoops. Okay, whatever. We'll go in. Cancel that. We'll go inside. And go to here. That'll be easy enough. You got anything? No. Yes. Okay. Okay. This will need a little bit more working, but what I will do first is I'm going to remove the requirement for names. Don't get that name. Nope. You don't get the name from here. Nope. And nope. And nope. Do I even need strings anymore? Yes, for this stuff. Decrease the surface just by a tiny bit. Goodbye. Yep, a lot of issues about to crop up. So, function gone. Nope. One line too many. Okay, vertex descriptor loader. No, but material does. Ah, yes, the pools finding by name also have to go away. Just the one function. It's getting the ID instead, not the name. Thank you. That does mean I now need that available. This is unfortunate. Okay. Bunch more locations, forget name, which is unfortunate. May have been just a little too soon to actually rip them out. But that's all I did do was just rip them out. So I can reset these guys and come back to this in a little while. A short little jaunt. While I grab a quick drink and think about how I'm going to approach this one. Okay. So what really probably should happen right now is we need a generic kind of like resource function that happens for like resource general or general. And this would be the one that brings in. So we'll have a couple of functions that are very basic. So it'll be like, it'll say what the declaration would it be the declaration? No, it wouldn't be writing the declaration, but it'll be the definition part. It'll deal with the group ID, the index ID, the resource ID, and the editor name, which are the generic parts right now, as well as maybe reading and writing of the type or getting version information. Yeah, okay. Resource basic, resource base info, I guess. So it'll be, it won't take in that, it'll take in, because honestly, I should remove the reading of the actual file from here, and it should just be the root node. So it'll be something a lot closer to what these guys do internally. So it'll be like, nope, not like this. It'll be like this. Taking the node. And then it'll have editor name map. I think, yeah, I think. That'll also include that. Definition, resource definition. Resource core, I guess. And this would also eventually include things like, you know, the version of the resource I'm bringing in, whether it's version one of the material, version two or three or whatever, so on. As well as maybe declaring it as a material type for confirmation? Maybe? Maybe. I think. Oh, that's dangerous. Actually, I'm thinking. Mesh public resource. Okay, I won't deal with this subnode nonsense. I'll assume I'm always on the node. Right here, as it is. So then we'll have to do a try. Do that. Okay, and then we'll have index ID. If that's the case, then we can read it in. Otherwise, this would also require that I need to know the something. Fix it in a moment. What I really care about is this. It's a string. Add resource, which will be the index ID, and the temp. It should really just from that. Okay. And then we'll have to have something similar on the other way, of course. We'll have like the resource. Like, I don't even have a core resource like piece right now, do I? Okay, but I can at least do this where I have the resource ID. Would be, yeah, it's basically those two right now anyways. Okay, that's true. I can just throw a bit easier in that case. If actually, or rather, I can just string. String to, oh, char one the string. Not saving anymore, or not playing is screwed up again. It's great. that resource. Yes, you'll be right about that. That indeed does not make any sense. Now I've got to deal with opening the files and spitting them into here, or do I want to try to take a stab at a class now? Not really. No, not really. Okay, what I will try to do though is. No, but I have to if I want to use it. Unless I'm going to use it from here? I can actually try it from in here just to see if it's going to work. Yes, I can do that. So. Resource HPP, and we go like. Oh, I have it for a null pointer. No, it's not going to work. Okay. Close everything to the right. Close that. Okay, we're going to have this. We're going to have a little function that's going to return a YAML node. File root node. Return file root node. Can we do try and catch? Maybe. I mean, if it throws an exception, then that's it anyway, so. I can put it around that, okay. Okay, whatever, we'll just do it this way. Root file node equals that, otherwise return. take this down to armature. There you are. If index equals ID, then we try. Then we have to do things with, port YAML resource core definition, which file root node, and ECS. ACS name map with the resource ID of whatever. This is where we confirm. The actual thing isn't declared. That's why. Okay. Otherwise, let me turn YAML, what was it, armature definition, which is their entry at this currently as well, and CI. Then we go into here. We don't have to read any of that stuff. We just deal with this. And then I'd get rid of that, keep this stuff. You're not gonna me rerun it? Is it just the fact that okay, so whatever. We do this, and then we're going to like pause it on a run. Test armature, which is the only one that has it. Okay, so that's looking better. Okay-ish. And then when I export these things, I'm going to have to kind of do the same thing. I need, like, I really do feel like I'm getting to the point where I need to, like, do another proper iteration of these resources. Because they're kind of messy. But I'm still kind of in the process of refining the how I'm interacting with them. And until I do that, I can't really rework these guys properly. Bunch of little things. Like, the general stuff is kind of independent rather than like a substruct that I can work with, or any number of other items, really. And I need the resource grouping mechanism. I need to kind of create a parallel. Or maybe fall back to using entity IDs for resources as well. With some kind, maybe, I mean, maybe I can and just like have one bit indicate whether it's a resource or not. That actually might work. Okay, I want to take another pause and think this over. Okay, so for IDs, I'm thinking moving back down to just using consolidating down to one ID type and having perhaps one bit of the ID be like a flip between an entity and a resource type, since I'm currently thinking those are the only two types I'm going to have. 1, 2, 3. If I continue with the groups, so I have like 2^4 groups, which is like, what, 16? I mean, what do I have right now? 2^28. It's 268 million indexes, indices per group, which is way more than I need. Incredibly way more than I need. Way more than could ever be held in memory, really. And what if, okay, if I was to shrink down, like what if I have like 8 bits reserved for non-indexes? So if I had 2^24, that's like 16 million indices. And I have like 2 7 bits for groups, which gives me 128 groups to work with. And then 1 bit, so I have 7 for the group, 1 bit for resource flag, and then I have the other 24 for the indices per group. That still gives me incredible amounts of flexibility. I'm thinking that is, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to consolidate down to one ID type. So resource ID will become like entity ID, but there'll be like a single bit. In the So foeECS num type bits equals one for the moment. We just have resource. So if it's like a zero, it's an entity. If it's a one, it's a resource. And then if we have two bits, that gives us like four to work with. Like if I do a 64, so it's like 64 groups, four types, and then whatever. And you know, if I move up to UN 64 for identifiers, then all this becomes moot. All this kind of, but I want to try to keep it down to UN32 for the moment, so that I can speed through finding items a bit easier. I have this old idea for how I do ECS, hold ECS data, and it's reliant on being able to speed through IDs quickly. I mean, technically, if I wanted to really hammer it down, I'd go to like a 16-bit, but that's way too small for putting all the data into an ID type. So we have that. So it's minus plus foeECS num type bits. Something like that. So the bit flag of valid group ID bits, index bits, plus foeECS num type bits. Valid index bits, move that over by that, some type bits, index value is that minus one, valid ID, index ID is that. So what maximum is, max group value is still 15, 0 to 15. Max index value is 134 million. I'm sorry? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What? Oh, right, because I'm still running with only four of these. If I was to do that, now that makes more sense. 1, 7, 1 leftover for indexes. So that leaves this to like 16. Yeah, okay. If I was to do 8, then it turns into 8 million. Okay. Now it makes a bit more sense. So leave it at 7, I think. E. So it goes up to a maximum of like 0xe or something like that. So I group ID, group ID, takes in from entity ID. Return if entity and I need the valid bits. Shifted over by the number of foeECS num index bits. How would I do this actually? I shifted over to the left, but that still leaves those other bits on the left. Shifted over by all of them. foeECS num group bits. That leaves the one bit left, and then we shift it back over to the right. By foeECS num group bits. Something like that. So that leaves. That's the one. 16 million? No, we're off by one. Shift it by that, minus one. Ay, ay, ay. $335 million? No. Take that and then shift it back to the right. Okay, no, shift it to the right by. ECS num group bits plus ECS num index bits. That gives us what, one, right? Not quite. 128. Why? Because this is only one bit, so it should technically be one, not whatever this is. Okay, do we want to do something that's similar to this? We're just going to do a foe entity ID to binary string. So standard binary. Is there one for that? It's oh, good, great. It's already breaking up. Standard hex. Hex oct decimal. Oh, I can just use set base. Okay. So base 2. Okay. Let's make sure nothing's breaking. Ah, lots of things are breaking. Fantastic. Why? Oh, because I didn't finish this, did I? Application, what we got in here? We got anything errors? We got some errors. Index equals string to UL of. Not assignable. Comparison between pointer and integer. Where is index? It's declared somewhere, right? What the hell's going on? Where's index in these ones? Index, okay, I just removed it somehow. Well, somehow, I obviously removed it. Okay, at the initialization stage, we're going to do to binary string of test ID. I'm going to check that out. What? Zero B that. Okay, was that's just that, Or zero if there's no binary? Why? It only works for 16, 8, and 10. Or zero. Sets numeric base of the stream when used an expression. Just the base field. Decimal and out prefix dependent input. Okay. Please, I want a binary version. Why doesn't set base 2 switch to binary output? Because the standard says so. Dang it. Guys, why would you do this? False hope. Okay, is there a way for me to do this? zero x, zero one, one two three, one two, one two three four. Okay, cancel that, save that. That's pointless. Doesn't work. This is what I'm looking for. I want that to be 16 million. No, that. Oh, that is right then. I was. Oh, of course I'd be stupid like that, wasn't I? Let me guess. I changed that up. Back that up. Back. Because valid index bits, max index value would be 214. Yeah, so it goes up to 215, right? Which is all the other bits. And then 216 would be this. This is right. Wow, I'm a moron. Okay, so. ECS max type value. Make it easier to read. So it's that shifted over by ECS num index bits. Equals, no, it'd be like this. Shifted over by that number of bits, right? Valid group bits shifted over by that. That shifted over by that is one. That, yeah, okay. Four bits for that. Shifts everything else over. And then really increases that. So I could do something like just six to really get large numbers of like 33 million. Minus one for the max index value, for the invalid index ID. It should be that. So this and that. Return entity and foeECS. Was it exclusive or is that? CTP XOR. Oh my God, could no one give a straight answer on Stack Overflow? That is exclusive or. Okay. I can work with that. Okay, what works still for now? That also should mean actually if I go to groups, right? Because this is all automatically updated. But I want to make sure. Groups. This was 16, now it's like foe is 63, 64 on 6. So if I actually change that to 7, this will also update to that. 126. That's the max value, 127. That's 127. That's 126. Then that should be 125. Because persistent will be minus one, and that'll be minus two. Yeah. Yeah. I'm thinking that's what I'm going to work with. Okay, so what order do I want to do this? I want to rename, or do I just want to, like, maybe what I'll do is I'll convert the resources to using this somehow. Well, I need to, like, group. Get generate like index generator right now does what? Okay. Generate entity resource ID, and that would be an entity. So this will be basically the same thing as that above. That or that would still be like the same thing, so not really too bad. num type bits or something like that. Didn't have to do the same thing. We'd have to get group ID. Nah, it's still the same. Then for this, we'd have to, and then get index ID. These are still the same. Rather new ID. Okay, we'll just stick with four for now, as it is. Make it clean so that at least the first four bits can go from 0 to F, hexadecimally. So it keeps it a bit easier to work with. Yeah, okay, so we generate the resource IDs. Okay, that's. I got a whole bunch of nonsense going on here. So, see if we can kind of get some of this out the way. foeID that something like that. Something like that. Index generator, along with index generator for that. Okay, then we want to do entity ID for IOManip string. Reworks those guys. Close these up. Num type bits and all this stuff. What's different here? It's been shifted over for some reason. allow for what each ID. Okay. So one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, can I just git stash all this stuff? Yeah. Unless I put type, at the far left, which I could do. I really don't know. I'm trying to think of all the possibilities. Okay, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to rename foeEntityID because it's not just entities, it's entities or resources. It's just going to be renamed down to like just foeID. It's just a generic ID type. Find it here. Okay, so all across everything, foeID, just like that. I'm going to change it to entity. It's going to become foeID ID. ID lowercase. Lowercase. Okay. Do it. All other locations of this becomes like that. It's going to have a whole bunch of, not actually that many files use it yet, so that's actually not too shabby. For ID, we'll do that. For group ID becomes foe group ID. ID group, like that. Okay. That becomes foeID type. Just the one, really. ID index. Like that. Whole bunch of. Gonna have a whole bunch of locations where entity needs to be replaced. I'm sorry? I didn't remove that file, did I? I don't recall removing that file. It's right there. Oh, the stash. The stash screwed me over here. Let's see, CSEML. Now we're a bit better. Bam. Okay. ID. And these guys got a. Okay. So ignoring that for the moment, you gotta do these ones. Entity ID. So it's not this, it's just foe. Do I really want to have the ECS group? Not really. I should probably just move it up here for the moment again. Just into foe. Foeid. HPP. Not double HPP. Just one, please. And we'll move these in a separate thing. But for the moment. ECS doesn't even include it, does it? That's what's going on here. Not test here. No, this doesn't have anything that's exported, so pretty okay on that. We'll have to I don't want these to be in line, really. Or maybe they should be. Anything other than an application? Not really. That needs to be changed to 2. Actually, no, leave it like that. There's no point in this yet. I don't even know why this is here, but I'll sure. As well. Okay, the name map is also going to be modified to not require all this anyways. So the name map can be actually largely reduced. Okay. Okay, well that's a largely reduced. That doesn't mean test those super in a bad way. Add, remove, find. And then we've got test, so adding two of the same ID but different editor names fails, okay. Okay, we don't need this anymore. Does what I have work? Well, seemingly. So let's see what we got to do. Okay, we'll put editor name. We're going to create a new subdirectory in foe for the ID type stuff. Put the editor name map and stuff in there. Editor name map is gone from here. Move groups index generator up to that as well. It'll be moved again someday, but not today, I'm sure. When I have a better place for it. I just don't know where yet. So, editor name map. There's basically nothing in here. That's great. This is just an interface library now. ECX export, you're right about that. It doesn't exist anymore. It's just faux export. Lot of issues on that one. Index generator. Okay, well, this is going to have to be shifted up. This can't work because there's already a foeYAML library. So this is going to have to be like foeCore. Name clashing. Ooh, not cool. Okay, if I go down here, libs foe that goes into libs. This should have a CMake list file, which it does. Yes, it does. Yes, it totally does have one. Or there's an error inside. No, that's the error. Inside of here. It's no longer an ECS. Oh, libs YAML does, but not libs itself. Okay, Okay. So we have that, then we go into here. Wait, where am I? Nope. Your foe core YAML, you are foe, yeah, no, you should have foe libs, yeah. Okay. And then these have to be changed over. Using foeID instead. But for the moment, I'll do this just to make it just a tiny bit easier. Move that over there. Okay. I need to stop doing that. I just need to, like, make one. Until we get something like that, where now we only have, like, one thing to do. Okay. This amazing. Amazing. Okay. This is probably because this is not including foeyaml. Okay, let's change this. It'll be like foeID YAML instead. That makes some more sense. Get rid of the hex dump. Don't care. Foey to foe. Libs for YAML, that foe core YAML is not built here. Okay. Now that, oh it's just not getting any easier. Why are you failing? Test, right? Foe. Why are you missing that? foeID YAML. Ah, yes. Oh, this just keeps going. Undefined references to all of these. Why? Foeid YAML export? Okay. And this is for the test. Foeid YAML. So okay. Okay, you know what? The answer is no. We're go back. We're just going to rename. No. This was a terrible idea. I'm not going to. Store these files. ECS, ECS. What we're going to do is we're going to move back. I'm going to slap the editor name map back into here. We're going to revert this, get rid of ID, bam. Back to this. We don't have that anymore. Now we're going to move the resource ID back. See, this is the problem why I have too much stuff, so I can't just like back out or revert the changes, because I got way too many changes from too many items ongoing at the same time, so I have to do this manually. This is painful. Got myself in a bad place. I'm gonna have to get dig myself back out. Okay, much closer. Gotta get myself into a good state again. Oh no! I missed. Oh, I forgot when I reverted. Those were new items. Maybe. Okay, maybe. Next groups. No. Well, actually, this might have it, right? Yes. Not too bad. Please put me back to where I was. Okay. Great. So it's okay. Let's the ID items. So you, okay, you. Discard those. ECS resource and all that stuff. Okay, we're back at this point. Great. What was I trying to do in the first place? I was moving them around for some reason. I was going to change this to like foe instead of foe ECS, be foeID. But you know what? I'll actually leave it as it is. I'm not even going to touch this. That was a pain in the ass and a huge failure of time. It's been another. Okay, this is stretching on long enough. I need to take a break. I'm going to leave it here for now. Cheers.